In this video, we're given 4 1-kilogram masses that are all tied together with strings. Those strings have unknown tensions that we're interested in solving for in part B. And so we're pulling on this system with a 10 Newton force pointing to the right, but the entire system is moving with constant speed because all those blocks are experiencing a kinetic friction force opposing that force to the right. In part A, we want to get that coefficient of kinetic friction that all the blocks are feeling. And again, in part B, we want to get all the unknown tensions and the strings that are connecting the blocks. Now, to answer part A, if that was the only question we were given, there's a really quick way of getting the answer to that. And I'll illustrate that first in this solution. But part B forces us into a more detailed analysis that could answer part A for us as well. So we'll look at the shortcut solution for part A, and then we'll do the full-blown problem so that we get part B. So for the shortcut method, the key is to realize you can treat the entire group of 4 1-kilogram masses as a single 4-kilogram mass. And the reason this works is that for the analysis of net force, all of those tensions are internal forces. So what happens, for example, with T1 is it pulls to the right on one of the blocks, but it pulls to the left on another block with exactly the same magnitude. So when we're adding up the sum of a bunch of internal forces, they contribute 0 to the vector sum of the forces. So we treat that 4-kilogram block as a single mass, and it experiences an external force of 10 newtons pulling to the right. And this block also experiences a friction force pointing to the left. And that friction force is related to the normal force by the usual equation, Fk equals mu k times the normal force, where mu k is the coefficient of kinetic friction. Now, to get at the normal force, we look at the force of gravity pulling down on this block. And that force of gravity is given by mg, where m is 4. We're using 9.8 as an approximation for g. And this gives us a weight of 39.2 newtons. Now, the normal force pointing up, that has exactly the same magnitude as the weight pointing down because there are no other forces interfering in the vertical direction. And I know the acceleration is 0 vertically, so those must balance. And I get a normal force of 39.2 newtons. This means my total friction force on the entire system is going to be 39.2 times the unknown coefficient of kinetic friction, mu k. Now we apply Newton's second law, F net equals ma. And the acceleration of the system is 0 again because we have constant speed here. And I have a 10 Newton force pointing to the right, so we'll make that the positive direction. And then I have 39.2 mu k, my friction force, pointing to the left. That takes a minus sign because it's pointing to the left. So we add 39.2 mu k to both sides and divide by its coefficient. And when we solve for mu k, we get 0.255. Okay, so that answers part A. And now to answer part B, one way to do it would be to start from the block all the way on the left. It experiences an unknown force of T1 to the right. Now that we have the kinetic friction coefficient, we can figure out the force of friction on that block. Then we apply Newton's second law and we can solve for T1. And so we'd work our way through the blocks from left to right, solving for T1, then T2, then T3. But because we have to get into the detailed analysis of looking at the forces on every single block anyway, I want to illustrate how you could attack that more general approach right from the beginning. So this is the alternative, more thorough solution to part A, and it naturally leads to the solutions for part B. So what we're going to do in this more systematic approach is just start from the left, work our way to the right, and look at the net force on every single block, and we know the acceleration of every single block is 0. So let's get the forces into the first block. And that first block is feeling a force of T1 pulling to the right, and then it has a friction force pulling to the left. And again, that's given by the coefficient of kinetic friction times the normal force. And again, the normal force on this is equal to the weight, so we'll pop those vectors in real quick. And that weight vector pointing down, that's mg again, but m is 1. So this gives us a weight of 9.8 newtons, which in turn means the normal force is 9.8 newtons. So this means our friction force is just 9.8 times mu k. Then we apply Newton's second law. So F net equals ma, where again, everything is moving at constant speed, so we know that A is equal to 0. And the net force on this block is just T1 pointing to the right minus that friction force pointing to the left, which is 9.8 mu k. Now, given that we've already used a trick to solve for mu k, you can see that it's really quick to solve for T1 here. But again, what I want to do at this stage is just illustrate the most general, detailed solution starting from the beginning. So there's our first equation. Then we apply the same kind of analysis to the next block. For the next block, the force diagram has one additional force compared to the first block. And the reason why is that the friction points to the left as it's dragged to the right, but T1 is also pulling it to the left. So I have a T1 pointing to the left, and I have an Fk pointing to the left. and of course I have a T2 pulling to the right, the weight of this block is exactly the same as the first one. That's 9.8 newtons, making the normal force again 9.8 newtons, and the friction force again 9.8 times mu k. Applying Newton's second law to the second block, I have T2 pulling to the right, and then I have two forces pointing to the left. That's T1 pulling to the left, so minus T1, and then Fk pointing to the left, so minus mu k times the normal force, or 9.8 mu k. That's all equal to zero again because the acceleration is zero. So at this point, the pattern is quick to recognize. My third block has a force of T3 pulling to the right. It has T2 pulling to the left and a friction force, which is equal to the same friction force on the first two blocks. And I can generate a third equation that's T3 pulling to the right, T2 pulling to the left, and that same magnitude of friction force because I have the same mass, 9.8 mu k pulling to the left. And that's equal to zero. And finally, we get a fourth equation for the block that's all the way on the right. And that has 10 newtons pulling to the right, T3 pulling to the left, 9.8 mu k pulling to the left. And that's equal to zero. So when we begin the problem with this more detailed analysis, we immediately see that we have a system of four equations and four unknowns. The unknowns are mu k, T1, T2, and T3. In other words, the answers to all the questions in the problem. So if we take this most general approach to the problem right from the beginning, instead of using this little shortcut to get mu k, we can just solve everything all at once. And we're conveniently set up to use elimination on this system. It's not that big of a deal to solve the system. If I add the first two equations, I see that the T1s are going to cancel and it generates another equation with a T2 in it and minus 2 times 9.8 mu k. Now I take that equation and sub it into the third equation. And when I do that, the T2s cancel, leaving me with a T3. And then I have a negative 2 times 9.8 mu k minus another 9.8 times mu k, so minus 3 times 9.8 times mu k is equal to 0. And then I sub that equation into the fourth one, and the T3s cancel, and I get 10 minus 4 times 9.8 times mu k is equal to 0. We add the 4 times 9.8 times mu k to the right-hand side and divide by its coefficient. This gives us exactly the same answer that we got with the shortcut, 0.255. Now again, if that's the only question that you were asked, the shortcut is better and faster. But part B forced us into this detailed analysis anyway. To find the tensions in the strings, I have to go back and sub in mu k. So we're going to start by finding T1, because that's the simplest equation. T1 is just 9.8 mu k, and we just plug in our mu k. And this gives us a tension of 2.50 newtons. Next, we've already generated an equation that has only T2 as the unknown. That was obtained by adding the first two of our original Newton's second law equations. So I have T2 minus 2 times 9.8 mu k equals 0. In other words, T2 is just twice 9.8 mu k. In other words, twice the previous answer for T1. So that's 5.00 newtons. And then finally for T3, again, we already created a simpler equation for it by using elimination. T3 is 3 times 9.8 mu k. In other words, 3 times T1, and that's 7.50 newtons. So we've got mu k, T1, T2, and T3, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.